Hi, this is Freddy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're going to talk about another knife from Miguel Nieto, who is a Spanish company that builds more of these traditional or hunting style folding knives and also some fixed blades. And the knife we're going to take a look at today is going to be their Pegaso model, and it looks like this. So a really nice, gorgeous handle scale here made out of wood. Then you have a backlock and also a nail nick two-handed opening. And they're a proprietary AN58 steel. And now let's take a look at the specs as always first. So we have an overall length here on the Miguel Nieto Pegaso of 7.5 inches or 19 centimeters. That gives us a blade length of 8 centimeters or 3.15 inches. We have a blade thickness of 3 millimeters. And the steel that they use is their proprietary AN58 steel that I could gather a lot of information about while using some other Miguel Nieto knives that I had so far. And let's take a look at the handle. We have here a handle length of 4.35 inches or 11 centimeters. So it's a good sized EDC friendly knife here from Miguel Nieto. Very, very ergonomic. Because of these finger grooves, fits my hand perfectly. Very nice and hand-filling handle here. And just a good size for some EDC tasks with a blade length of just over 3 inches. And we have also this really nice traditional pen-style blade shape and a nice hollow grind. Now let's take a look at the weight of this knife. And it weighs 100 grams or 3.5 ounces. So a reasonable weight for an EDC knife in my opinion, and you have to see you have here a backlock mechanism, which certainly is going to add a little bit in the weight department, and also some unskeletonized stainless steel liners here on the inside. I hope I can show you that. So that is certainly going to add a little bit of weight, and you also have a stout 3 millimeter thick blade spine here. But overall, it doesn't feel too heavy. It feels about right when you hold it in your hand that a knife of this construction and size should feel like. And I have no complaints here about the weight on the Miguel Nieto Pegaso. Now let's take a closer look at the 3.15 inch long blade. And you can see you have this nice traditional style pen type blade shape, which is a slight drop point here. And then you have your nail nick for opening the knife. Then you have a pretty pronounced hollow grind here on the knife as well, so you're going to get a nice and fine edge from the 3 millimeter of blade spine, nice and thin behind the edge, so it's going to be quite a nice slicer. And then you can also see that you have some flat part here where you can find all the logos for Nieto, then the name of the blade, which is Pegaso, that it is made in Spain and that it uses their proprietary AN58 steel. So the AN58 steel is a steel that really impressed me because it certainly outperformed its chemical composition. I really had no issues with that steel. It is certainly not a high-end steel or anything like that, but a good all-around user steel. It's going to be very rust resistant and hold the edge for a good amount of time. And also the toughness is certainly adequate for a folding knife and even for a fixed blade. If you're interested how it performed on a fixed blade, take a look at my review of the Miguel Nieto fixed blade that I have reviewed so far. But overall, nothing to complain here about this steel, especially in the price point that these knives come in. So certainly a good all-around user steel here, especially because it's really rust resistant. Now let's take a closer look at the handle construction and design. And you can see here that you have a very, very gorgeous violet wood handle that has been carved and contoured to really fit your hand very well. It's one of the most ergonomic knives I have in my collection. Really, really impressive how they could make this wood handle really fit your hand like a glove. And you can also see that it looks very nice with these alternating carvings that they have done here in the handle. And one thing that you can notice right away is that the construction of the handle is pinned by these 4 pins here, so you are not going to be able to take this knife apart. But I think that is more a feature of the overall traditional style of this knife and not something that really detracts from it, because most of these traditional style knives, slip joints or backlock, are pinned together construction like the Buck 110 or most of the GEC or case knives. So I'm actually not that concerned about the pin construction on a traditional knife like this. And then you can also see that you have a very interesting feature here around the pivot, which is actually a pivot color that is inlaid into the violet wood right here. and it is also some kind of different wood, and they have done a very nice job by filing that down. There is no transition perceivable with your finger. Really well done here, and that's something you absolutely don't see on knives that are in this price range of the Pegaso. So a very nice feature, and also really nicely executed. Also, the other pins are nicely polished down, so you don't feel any kind of transition or sharp corners. Everything is done really well, and here on the back you can see the very well executed file work on the back spacer. Here you have some more spaced out file work, and here in the front on the liners you have some finer one as well. So really well done, and you can also see that the liners and the back spring has been polished. So very nice fit and finish all around. And here on this side you can see you don't have the pivot collar on this side, only on the presentation side, and just the three rivets that hold the knife together, and the same really gorgeous violet wood. Very, very nicely done here, and a gorgeous wood choice. There are some other handle materials here on the Pegaso. There is also a green micarta handled version and a olive wood handled version, if I'm not mistaken. So there are three different handle materials you can choose if you want to get yourself your own Miguel Nieto Pegaso, which is always a really nice thing that they offer multiple different handle materials for most of their knives. Then the locking mechanism of this knife is of course the back lock, as you have heard there, and that works really well. So there is no up and down play, no side to side, really well executed here. And then you just push back here on the back lock and it closes like that. Also, the handle is extremely ergonomic, as I said before. It really fits your hand like a glove. You can see here how the finger fall in place very well here on the design on this handle. You can really bear down and you have absolutely no hot spots. Of course, there is no pocket clip, so that could be a hot spot on a lot of knives, but here you don't have that. And it's a really, really nice knife in hand. You can bear down really hard and you don't have any hot spots here in the hand. Very, very nice and ergonomic handle. Now let's take a closer look at the centering and action of this knife, and you can see here that the blade is slightly off center to the left, but not rubbing the liner, so not a big concern there. And you can also see that the tip of the blade is far in the handle, so you're not going to catch the blade with your thumb like that. And you can also see the really nice fit and finish here on the backspacer and the liners. There are no gaps there. Really well done overall. So the centering could be improved slightly, but it's not that big of an issue here. And the action is quite smooth here. Of course, you always have the pressure of the back lock that is running on the tang of the blade there, but it certainly is very smooth, as you have seen here. Maybe I can show you that here in this perspective. The blade falls freely when you disengage the back lock, and if you lock it up, there is absolutely no play in the back lock. So really well executed here on the lockup of the knife. And the one thing I forgot to show you before is here a shot of the cutting edge right there. You can see that it is quite thin, but one thing that I would like to see as an improvement is a slightly larger sharpening choil, because you can see it is quite a small one here, and you just are going to hit the Ricasso while you're sharpening that blade. So a slightly larger sharpening choil, maybe a bit like here, would be a nice thing. But other than that, I'm really happy with the fit and finish, lockup, and the overall execution of this knife. And I really love the very ergonomic handle here. It fits my hand actually really like a glove, so very well done there. Now let's take a look at the sharpness of this knife. I now had it for about 3 weeks in my EDC rotation, and also took it a little bit in the outdoors and carved a little bit with it and did some things like that. So let's take a look at how sharp the AN58 steel is after all that use, and test it on our review paper right here that we do with all of our knives. And let's see how sharp it still is. It came very sharp out of the box, like all the Miguel Nieto knives that I had so far, and you can see it still can slice paper quite easily. In the front it's a little bit less sharp than in the back. Maybe you can hear or see a difference there. But the whole edge can really easily slice paper without any problem, as you can see here. Very well done here on the edge retention and the initial sharpness on the AN58 steel blade on this Miguel Nieto Pegaso. Now let's come to the size comparisons that I like to do. And first off, I'm going to compare it to a custom knife that I have since quite a long time, and it is going to be the Oda Knives OFF FK7, which is a friction folder with some gorgeous Japanese cherry wood handle scales and a D2 blade. So a knife that is going to be legal in pretty much all places I know. And it's also a more traditional style knife like the Pegaso, in my opinion. And you can see here size-wise that the Pegaso is quite a bit longer. If I put them here back to back like that, you can see that you have quite a bit of a difference in the overall size of the OFF FK7 and the Pegaso from Miguel Nieto. And the next comparison that I have for you is going to be a knife from Miguel Nieto itself that I have reviewed recently. And it's going to be the Wasp by Miguel Nieto with these gorgeous Coca Bolo handle scales in this bamboo carving style. Same AN58 steel. And you can see here that the Wasp is going to be slightly smaller. The handle is nearly identical, but you lose a little bit there in the blade. If I put them here again back to back, you can see that there is a slight difference in the blade length there. Otherwise, those two knives are very similar, but here you can actually adjust the pivot via this pivot screw. Really love to carry that, a nice small gentleman style carry, also with the really well-executed hollow grind, so a really nice slip joint here, the Miguel Nieto Wasp. Then the last comparison I have for you is going to be another non-locking knife, so a very legal one, but in a more modern interpretation, and it's going to be the Viper Down 2. So a really nice, easy, one-handed openable, non-locking folder. This one also has a clip and some micarta handle scales and the N690 steel from Böhler Uddeholm. And these two are very close in the overall size. You can see here the Pegaso has still a longer blade, so the Pegaso actually has the longest blade of all the three knives that I have shown you here, and the hand lengths of all of them are quite similar. Now let's talk about value and price and come to a final conclusion about this knife. So if you want to get yourself your own Miguel Nieto Pegaso in one of the three different handle materials that are available, you're going to pay just around or under $40 depending on where you're getting it. And I think for that amount of money, you're really getting a big bang for your buck. You get a good all-around EDC steel that is very stainless and still holds the edge for a good amount of time. You get very, very gorgeous handle materials on either one you're going to choose. You have some really nice custom features like the pivot collar and the really, really nice fit and finish. I haven't found anything that isn't right here on this knife. Everything is rounded and contoured, polished and fitted really well. You have a solid lockup with the back lock here, a nice universal pen style blade shape, and just an overall gorgeous, more traditional Aura hunting style folder. And the ergonomics on this knife really blew me away. It is the most ergonomic traditional knife that I have handled so far. Really, really nice and hand filling, nice and contoured wood handles. And all of these grooves here in the handle really fit my particular hand very, very well. As I have said before, I have small to medium hands. So for that hand size, they really did an awesome job by contouring this handle to be very, very comfortable even for prolonged use. And as you can see here on this little shot on the table, you can see some other Miguel Nieto knives that I have, and I think you can tell that I'm quite a fan of this Spanish company. They really put out some good looking designs that have all very, very gorgeous handle material choices. You have here micarta, then you have tuya wood, and here you have Coco Bolo, and all of these knives come in different variations. And they recently also upgraded their steel a little bit to a 12C27 Sandvik here on this model and some others, and that is certainly a really nice direction that they are going to, and they still keep all of their knives very affordable even though they are very, very well made, and just represent an enormous value in the realm of more traditional folding knives that are made in Europe. So I'm a big fan of Miguel Nieto, and the Pegaso is no exception there. Very ergonomic lockback style knife in a more traditional overall package. And this was my review. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.